When moving from an environment where you have limited storage solutions, it's nice to know that you have flexibility to find the best solutions to use when concerning your storage choices in AWS. For this session, we'll quickly review three of the most commonly used storage solutions available for you. Starting with the most commonly used and default block storage mechanism in AWS, Amazon Elastic Block Store, or EBS. This provides block-level storage volumes for use specifically with EC2 instances. EBS volumes behave like raw, unformatted block devices that you can mount as devices to your instances. And while you can mount multiple volumes on the same instance, each volume can only be attached to one instance at a time. You can create a file system on top of these volumes or use them in any way you would use a block device, such as a hard drive. Additionally, you can dynamically change the configuration of a volume attached to an instance. Within EBS, there are several configurations open to you, and the volume types that you can choose include both SSD and traditional HDD options. The general purpose volume is the most common type and the default volume used by Amazon EC2. General purpose SSD volumes provide strong levels of performance for a wide variety of workloads. The provision IOPS SSD, or PIOPS volumes, offer you some of the highest performance SSD volumes for mission-critical low-latency or high-throughput workloads. You also have the ability to adjust the level of performance you may require. These are best utilized when you need consistent and high levels of performance. For our HDD volumes, we have another two options for you to consider. For the throughput-optimized volumes, these are for frequently accessed throughput-intensive workloads. While it's not the fastest type of storage in EBS, it is a great balance of cost and functionality. The other type of HDD EBS volume is the cold HDD volume. These are going to be best suited for scenarios where the lowest cost block storage is of utmost importance. The major difference between throughput optimized and cold HDD is, unsurprisingly enough, the throughput. Both are designed to be cost-effective options. If you're planning a higher throughput need, but still with lower overall I/O per volume, then the throughput optimized would be the way to go. If, on the other hand, you need a higher I/O on the volumes, the SSD options are still going to be better choices. So that's about EBS. But the title of this video also mentions that we'll be talking about Amazon Elastic File System. So where is it? Well, lucky for you, that's my next topic on this video. Elastic File System, also known as EFS, allows you to create a file system, mount the file system on EC2 instances, and then read and write data to and from your file system. And while that may sound strikingly familiar to what we just covered, it does. There are some major differences, though. First off, EFS can be mounted to multiple EC2 instances at the same time. This enables you to have a shared file system for multiple servers. Secondly, EFS is just that, a shared file system. EFS is a file storage system that uses NSF v4 and currently supports versions 4.0 and 4.1, though we do recommend that you use the most recent version. EFS does provide another difference that you can utilize, and this becomes incredibly important while running multi-environment workloads, like when migrating. That other difference is that your AWS-housed EFS can be mounted to by on-premise servers. So now that we've looked at EBS and EFS, let's take a look at our last topic for this section, Amazon Simple Storage Service, also known as S3. S3 is an object storage system that was intentionally built with a minimal feature set that focuses on simplicity and robustness. To use S3, all you do is create a bucket, which is a container for your objects, and then start loading in the objects. The objects are fundamental entities stored in S3, which consist of the object data and metadata. While the object's data is opaque to S3, the metadata is a set of name-value pairs that describe the object. In S3, Once you've created the bucket, you can work with objects either through API or directly through the console. Though S3 is a natively internet-based service, meaning that access is provided through internet-accessible endpoints, it does not mean that there is any loss or compromise on how secure your data is. Through access control lists, bucket policies, encryption options, and additional security features, you have full and granular control on how you grant access to objects in your buckets. In terms of migration, S3 is unique in that it can be used not only to store objects for your applications to utilize after migration, but can also be a great location to store images, backups, database dumps, and other components that are used while migrating. So while you're planning out your migration, be thinking about what the best storage option for your various workloads might be. Test and experiment with them and find out what provides the most optimal performance to meet your needs.